I'm 32 years old at this point, and a lot of times it feels like my story was told in the wrong order. Looking back now, there's a bunch of moments where I think I could have given up, especially when I got to the point, you know, in my late 20s and nothing had happened. I finally got to the point, I was like, I'm spreading myself thin, I'm trying to be an artist, I'm trying to produce records, and I've got nothing to show for it. You know, if I am making good art, no one's listening to it, so what does it matter? I don't know, like, you start to be like, well, maybe I'm not good. Maybe my parents were right. Maybe this is self-indulgent.
There's something about being in those cultures where your success is what makes your identity and what makes you valuable. But the funny thing is like all these people bank on that ideal, and then 15 years from now when they have none of that, they're like, who am I?
It's easy to sacrifice yourself and say, well, I'm just gonna eat ramen noodles and I'm never gonna buy any new clothes. I'm just gonna save money because I believe that this is what I'm supposed to do. But when you have someone else, whether it's your family, whether it's your wife, whether you have a child, your dream now is not only you sacrificing, but it's other people having to sacrifice for you. And there was many times where I almost broke down and just gave up. But but I didn't.
You spend so much time focusing on money, success, goals, fans, but I didn't start writing songs for them. I started writing songs because it was my way to express how I felt. I just think it's scary to place your identity into things.
I'd been in bands where we had had the perfect marketing plans and we'd played all the shows and we'd done everything right, and it just never worked out. And then with Missio, it's like we did everything wrong and it worked out. And the lesson there is not do everything wrong. The lesson is don't give up.